दान जबान सुना गल मेरी के दुनिया दर लाना या दुनिया कोल चार दिहाड़ खाग मिट्टी रड़ जाना आई बार बसाख्यो बाली मुड़ पे आलोक करानो आई बार बसाख्यो बाली मुड़ पे आलोक करानो मेले गो कद अल्लाह मेरे आले गई मौत जड़ाना
The chronicles suggest that even before, when the British colonizers established the Indian Forest Department in 1861, and a state could identify and standardize the ownership and control of resources of forest, the Wildlife Protection Act 1972 and Forest Dwellers and Tribals Act 2006 could come into existence when Gujjars, who were actually nomadic buffalo herders, have been inhabiting the forests at the foothills of Himalayan states of Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. There are many tribes who have lived in deep dependence on wild habitats in India, for whom transhumance or the practice of moving livestock from one grazing ground to another in a seasonal cycle has been a way of life for centuries. Their customs, cultures and traditions are cattle-centric. They believe that for their sustenance and existence, cattle, mainly buffalo, has been an unequivocally significant aspect of their lives since generations. One Gujjars of Uttarakhand's mountain trek down from Uttarkashi to Rishikesh and Dehradun during winters with their livestock at their deras, that is, habitation pockets in the forests. Currently, they shelter in Chila and Motichur forest ranges of Rajaji National Park, and also they have habitation in Tarai pockets of Udham Singh Nagar, district of Uttarakhand. Talking about their social arrangement, when Gujjars predominantly follow Islam, however, they follow caste system which is influenced by Hindu Gotra system. The castes of Van Gujjars that are majorly found in Uttarakhand are Kalis, Kasani, Lodha, Khatana and Tinde. They usually speak Gujru and Dogri dialects and Punjabi, Hindi and Urdu languages. Religion-wise, majority of them are Muslims who follow Sunni sect and believers of Islam. They do 5 times namaz, prayers according to Islam, but they seem to be happy with simple lifestyle and free from Wahhabism or fanatic Islam. Socio-economic aspect. Van Gujjars reside in deep forests which are protected by forest laws. So, therefore they are devoid of making any kinds of permanent settlements, access to electricity, water supply, roads or practice agricultural any forms, etc. Hence, they are dependent predominantly on cattle rearing for their sustenance. However, they have to give some nominal allowance per buffalo to the forest department for permit. In addition to this, the other ingredients constituting in mineral mixture that are added with fodder have to be purchased from outside, sometimes in cash and sometimes in the form of debt. Cattle, in terms of buffalo, a maize or bhais, which are generally of desi or local breeds, starts lactating after 5 years and has lifespan of 15 to 17 years. The chota or the male buffalo is being changed accordingly for fetching the better variety of cattle in their herd, mainly for milk production. Generally, after the death of cattle, they bury them and rarely give the carcass to the butcher. Their hereditary occupation of cattle rearing can be seen in their customs when it comes to marriages. They follow mutual exchanges of gifts during marriages to the bride. Groom's family gives meher, a gift given to the bride, in the form of buffalo. Bride brings a sanduk, wooden or metal chest, bed, clothes, along with her, and sometimes a buffalo too. This is called daj or dowry. Earlier, they used to practice early marriages, but now the ideal age of marriage is considered to be 17 to 18 years and above in their community for both boys and girls. The nikah, marriage, ceremony is performed in traditional way after the mutual consent of both husband and wife, and the ceremony is conducted by the Maulvi, Islamic religious priest. Verbal commitments are more valuable than legal works in the community. They follow Islamic way of cremation after death. There is no change in general lifestyle and eating habits during this phase. According to Sunnah, the body of literature which discusses and prescribes the traditional customs and practices of the Islamic community, both social and legal. The boys generally have khatna or the circumcision at the age of 2.5 to 3 years. When Gujars live simple life, they eat normal simple North Indian food, that is dal, roti, sabzi, etc. Women avoid cooking during menstrual days, but if no one is available, then she may cook. After the child's birth, a woman may be served with dalia, halwa or kheer for 40 days. And as such, they don't have any special cuisine. Their bona fide need, which includes ration, is met after selling the milk. Generally, they practice vegetarianism. However, during Bakra Eid, they eat goat, which is of halal. The main source of nutrition of one Gujars is the pure milk and its different derivatives such as ghee, butter, curd, cheese, buttermilk, etc., which stimulates them to gain vital nutrients, make their muscles, bones, and develop strong immune system. They have hard-working routine and thrive in pollution-free green vicinity, which helps them generally to be free from sedentary lifestyle and non-communicable diseases. Festivals and cultures. Shab-e-Barat is celebrated 15 days before Ramadan, 9th month of the Islamic calendar, observed by Muslims worldwide as a month of fasting, prayer, reflection and community. They celebrate Ramadan and Eid al-Zuha, the festival of sacrifice. Halwa, kheer, sevia, etc. are main traditional foods cooked during the festivals. Talking about their education, the children of one Gujars get talim or education of Urdu, Arabic and Islam as religion from a Maulvi who comes in their habitation and educates them. However, in recent years, they have started getting education from government schools ever since there has been an augmentation in interaction with the outside world. Women. For every society to flourish, women is the locus point of any development. In the tradition of one Gujars, if a woman becomes a widow, then according to their customs, after 4 months and 10 days, she can get married to anyone among the remaining brothers of her late husband in her in-laws' family. If all the brothers are already married, then by mutual consent, she can get married as second wife with the chosen brother. If by chance there is no brother, then with a cousin of her late husband, she would get married. They do not discriminate with widow in terms of any custom or food habits. Widow females are not allowed to wear ornaments, but otherwise their living lifestyle remains the same. They wear light colored clothes and cannot apply makeup after in any form or wear attractive jewelry. Art, dance, music. Women are not allowed to sing songs or dance either in any form or in any functions or events that happens in the community or otherwise. Though some women are now getting in touch with dance and music because of the recent changing trends and their interaction with the technology. However, only males are allowed to sing during special events like marriages. Generally, men sing folklores in their local dialect, Gujari or Punjabi, during the Mehndi ceremony or during the other events of marriages. Utensils. When it comes to kitchen, they use utensils made up of mud, brass, aluminium, steel and plastic because usually it's trending and plastic is being cheap. Ornaments. It is mandatory for every married woman to pierce her nose in order to wear a special type of ornament called phuli, a long traditional nose pin, which is usually in gold. They wear silver ornaments on ear because gold is sometimes too expensive to own. Women tie their hair beautifully with paranda, a decoration of a braid tassel, which is generally self-made instead of using rubber bands. Bangles are either of glass and plastic that are worn in hands. They also wear payal or the anklets on their feet. Customs. Earlier women used to wear traditional dress called susi, but now they wear simple suit salwar, traditional Punjabi women dress. Generally, for women, it is mandatory to cover their heads. However, they don't have burqa or hijab, a head covering worn in public by Muslim women system. Architecture and engineering. One Gujjars live in magnificent giant huts which are 25 feet average in height, but they can vary in different sizes and can accommodate 10 to 18 people accordingly. The khamba, that is the central pillar, is the main supporter for the whole structure. There are many kolris or ballis supporting wood planks for carrying foos or the hatch on the top of the hut. These huts are well plastered with mud and cattle dung mix. The walls are partially opened for the ventilation and they hardly have any doors in the home. Their belongings are kept safely in trunks. These huts can cost about 1.5 to 2 lakhs to them. There is a small gana or the fireplace burning at the center of the hut during winters and monsoon to keep them warm and free from flies and insects. At the center or near to cattle sheds or barns of deras, there is a tola, a raised place which is covered with thatch that is used for feeding cattle. Medicinal knowledge. These forest dwellers seek medicinal care in terms of illness and traumas from hospital or nearby clinics. They don't keep traditional knowledge of herbs and have basic general home remedies at home. Earlier, it was prohibited to opt for surgery, but now they are heading towards safe delivery practices. For recreation, one Gujjars play a special game of Mukdar, whereby a man testifies his manhood and strength by lifting a tree trunk weighing minimum up to 25 to 50 kgs from a single hand in a single shot and continues to hold it up high as he can, and then throws it back to the ground. Sometimes when this is being played, mutual marriages may also pursue it, depending upon the performance of an individual. This is an attempt in the form of audio-video composite knowledge repository to showcase the culture and tradition of one Gujjars who have been thriving in Uttarakhand very well, even with limited resources. Thanks for watching.